love you. Making that coconut blended coffee that I always make. So you know, that requires some coconut oil. I literally just woke up, you guys. This is aside from taking Banks out, and yes, that is Banks on my shirt. This is the first thing I do every morning. Make some coconut coffee. And now we blend. Usually I do this with two hands. Clearly that's a requirement. That's all that is, you guys. It's black coffee with coconut oil, like half a tablespoon, and it makes it so creamy. Okay, so another thing I just want to show you from my morning routine is the 5-minute journal. This has helped me so much just in like my perspective and like mental health. I want to preface this by saying, you guys, I suck at journaling. I'm not a journaler. This journal has prompts, which I just find helps so much. So it kind of reminds you to check in with what you're grateful for, what you want to accomplish in the day, and then you set a daily affirmation. For example, something like, I am worthy of everything I get in life, or I'm deserving of love, or just whatever, something you need to hear that day. And then you fill it out at night as well. Three amazing things that happened today, so things that you maybe didn't even think were amazing in the moment, but like getting a really amazing coffee or just FaceTiming with a friend these days, things like that. And then my little hack that I tell everybody is, how could I have made today even better? I didn't love this question, to be honest, especially in quarantine, because I feel like all of us are already doing our best. So I started changing this one to something I'm excited for tomorrow, and it has just like helped me look forward to the little things. But it could even just be as like simple as going to get a coffee, or like you're gonna try a new workout, or you're gonna go for a walk, or maybe you have something more exciting on, like you're gonna get your hair done. So yeah, this is truly a game changer for me. I don't have that much left of it. I need to order a new one because there's like notes and stuff in the back. I think it takes you through about 6 months. And I've done all of these. So I will link this in the notes, but honestly, it is so worth it. And it's such a good gift too. I've given this to so many friends. So if you need something to get someone for a Christmas gift or a holiday gift, it's like, I think $30-$40, which I realize can be a little bit more on the pricey side for a journal, but so freaking worth it. Okay, just finished a Sammy Clark workout. I've been trying to do 2 days on, 2 days off while my body like adapts back into working out. I kind of want to look naked right now, but you guys, I am wearing a sports bra. So yeah, anyways, that was a killer workout. My ass is sore already. My abs are gonna be sore tomorrow, but good workout. And now I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do. Like, I'm in a mood where I just am lazy today. Not lazy, but just not productive, you know? So Caitlin is dancing in less than 2 hours, so I'm gonna go, I think, do like a 10-minute tidy. I've kind of destroyed my place a little bit today just with nicks and knacks that I was pulling out. I just said nicks and knacks like I'm a 77-year-old. Cool. Anyways, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna stop talking before I say something else weird. I am making, I can't remember if I've shared this on the vlog before, to be honest, but I've got buttered cauliflower cooking right now. I've got the rice, the cauliflower that I dropped, but this is too hot to clean. That is where we're at right now. It is Dancing with the Stars time. I gotta go change the screen. I'm gonna go work on some holiday gift guides and call it a night for the vlog. So I also have to edit last week's still. So can someone tell me how to like find more than 24 hours in a day? Cause that'd be cool, thanks. Okay, I know I said I was done for the night, but like look how melty and like soaked up this cauliflower is.
Ugh. Get in my belly. Okay, now I'm done. Bye.
All right, friends. Obviously, you can see it's Wednesday, which means I skipped day of the week. This was not feeling. I don't know why I chose to do this while making coffee, because now it's going to be loud. I'm sorry. But I just wasn't feeling up to having the pressure of doing the vlog yesterday. I just wanted a chill day. I had a lot on my work schedule, and we're not about perfection here, right? So I just gave myself that break. But I am back, and nothing really exciting going on today, but we'll see what I get up to. I'm out of the house because I wanted to go shoot a look, and this is what I do, you guys. I just drive around looking for a wall and a place where it's kind of hidden so that people don't, it's not like on a main street, so people don't see me in my tripod. It's an embarrassing life. You know, I'm just slowly working my confidence level up for shooting stuff, so this is like why having an Instagram boyfriend would be great. No other reason that I want a boyfriend other than that. Okay, I'm gonna go shoot on that wall over there.
Good morning, friends. I don't know what that voice was. Still not sure why I'm doing it.
I am going for part two of this hair journey, and that will be getting extensions. So yeah, I'm gonna take you along, and we're gonna say goodbye to Banks first.
Goodbye, love bug. Are you a cutie cutie? Are you a cutie patootie? Boop. Okay, I love you. Be a good girl.
Okay, I'm at Cali. We're gonna do hair extensions. This is Janelle. Hi. And she's gonna explain, because I actually don't know what's going on, what we're gonna do.
So, this is how it's gonna look on your head. When you brush, we want you to go right over top of it, like that. We wanna also get kind of in between the wefts and brush them out, because I'll walk through kind of how this works in a second, but what you'll want to do is just what can happen if these hairs are kind of all sandwiched together and they rub, you can just get mad. So what we do with the placement is for the bottom rows, so that this is how the beads are, this will all be the same color, we just put it with different colors so that you can see it. So we'll do your bottom rows upside down so that when you tie your hair up, the beads are hidden. Yes. And then your top rows are the beads will be underneath, just so that your hair can lay flat on top. Yeah, we'll have to, like, we could do it and not tone them down, but I think to make it look like perfect, I think we should tone them just slightly cooler.
Okay. I am back. I got some extensions, to be honest. This isn't how I would curl my hair, so like I'm just not, it's just different. And that's, I don't like when anyone curls my hair, so I really hope the girl who curled my hair is not watching right now. I feel really bad. I got more hair, guys, and I'm really excited. It's long, you can see, and I will show you tomorrow how I would style it. Okay, I am running some errands. I've got to get some groceries, but I just realized I forgot to put on deodorant. Love that. I mean, good thing we have to stay 6 feet apart from each other, because I'm gonna do that. And then I got a podcast this afternoon. And then tonight, I am going to put on Christmas music, decorate my place, or like a Christmas movie, and just get in the zone. So you get to decorate with me. Okay, anyways, toodaloo. Just finished the podcast with Meg, and you guys, this episode is gonna come out on Wednesday. Like, it was powerful. I just kept sitting there, like, kind of not really knowing what to say next, because I was still processing what she had just said so intentionally and wisely. And I just think it's such an important conversation for us to be having, and I think as women especially, we'll almost, like, I can feel like all of you will relate to that episode in one way or another. Like, I feel like I can say that almost with a guarantee. I had chills the entire time. I cried. Ugly cry. I have an ugly cry, but I also have an ugly cry voice. There's just no hope for me. I just cannot recommend this episode that's coming out enough. So Wednesday, set your alarms. Please listen. Follow Meg on Instagram. It's meg.boggs with 2 G's on Boggs. And speechless. And that noise in the background is Banks licking her toes. Banks. Busted. The Christmas tree. I just want to fall my own. More than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. I just popped some spaghetti squash in the oven and I am about to set up the tree. Those are Christmas decorations. I know garbage is usually there, but those are actually Christmas decorations. And I've got some fresh cranberries I'm gonna put in a vase. I also don't have all my Christmas decor yet because there is some new stuff I wanted to get that I'm waiting for to be delivered, but tonight just felt like the night to unplug. It's Friday. I need something to be excited about, so I'm gonna decorate and I will show you how it goes. So the debate I'm having in my head right now is whether to put the tree here or in Banks's spot. Like, I love the idea of having it there while I sit on the couch, but I'm also gonna put a garland up there and stockings and make it super festive. And then I feel like that's just gonna be the Christmas area of my house. Or I could have a tree right there and have garland there and like splooshes. Thoughts? What do you vote? Okay, the tree is up. I chose this spot, as you can obviously tell. I've only got these big ass ornaments on it right now. I'm gonna put garland on here that I'm waiting for, so I just thought this would break up the Christmas decor, and my kitchen is a mess. Starting a second Christmas movie, and my little helper is no help at all. Thanks. Do you want to come decorate the tree for me?
Love you.
Oh, that face. This face, just look at this face. Okay, the Christmas vibes are here. The kitchen is now clean. This sitch is like a little baby sitch. I don't know, I gotta figure that out. We've got this little paper tree, and this is actually a little candle. And then I'm gonna put something in that frame. I just don't really know what yet. And then we've got the tree over here. She is beautiful. She is cozy. So that is the vibe. Cause now when I walk through the door, I'll see her and I'll just feel all festive. And then the fireplace over here is gonna have some big garland on it with some candle. I want to say candelabras, but that's not it. Like candlesticks and little just stockings hanging from it. So that is still to be done. I don't have the stuff yet, but we have made major progress and I'm so tired. So I'm going to go to bed and wash my face and take that little goober.
Mood.
Good morning. My hair kind of looks like Lord Farquaad from Shrek if I were to do like little bangs that went straight across right now, just the way it's curled in. This is a little better. Anyways, good morning. It is Saturday. It felt so nice to wake up and to have my tree all lit. On today's agenda, first thing is my coffee. essentials. Also, by the way, this is these mugs are huge. I always spill coffee on the sides, so I don't mind that, but literally, like, that's the size of my head. They're 20 ounces, which is like a Starbucks venti, and it is the brand that I used to own called State of Grace. I started that brand, but I sold it this summer to an amazing mother-daughter duo, Brandy and Mackenzie. Where I'm going with this is that they are great Christmas presents. They are great stocking stuffers. They are around the $25 mark. I know it's a pricier mug, but you guys, when people get these in person, they don't realize how big they are. They're so good. They're my favorite mug, stocked is what I meant to say. I can't get over my hair right now. There's no hope for me. But yeah, I gave them as gifts all the time. I still will. And check them out. Anyways, that was a tangent off of me needing coffee this morning. And then I'm gonna get ready. I need to stop playing with my hair. Me and no makeup is just not a vibe, you know? Not this morning anyways. So yeah, anyways, today I'm gonna go to do a few errands for something that I am planning that I'm going to announce in this vlog that I'm really, really excited about. So I'm not gonna, actually no, I'll tell you where I'm going because it won't ruin it. But I have to go to Fort Langley today, which is like the cutest little historic area that we have here. So we'll be doing that. I'm gonna try and just be in and out because of everything going on. I don't like to really go places right now, but I have to go there to get something. So stay tuned. Okay, I'm gonna stop now. Okay, so I'm out of the house, as you can tell. I'm about to go into, notice how like I just don't even have to put on a lip anymore. Just gotta put on the mascara and do the brows. I'm going into a local business here called Little White House. They have the cutest stuff. They do like high tea for Mother's Day, and yeah, it's just a really, really cute place. So I will share some video of it, but I am here for work purposes. I have to pick up some stuff for the exciting announcement that's coming soon. My nose contour looks a little messed up. No, I think it was just lighting. I don't know. Okay, let's go. Oh, that's twisted. Oh no, oh no. Got it.
We just walked the same way again.
Okay, how cute is this place? So Christmassy. Okay, so every room is like merchandised, kind of like a house. And it's so, so cool. It's like lights and mirrors and clothes. Okay, I picked up some goods. Cannot wait to show you guys what I got. You will see what is coming. I'm so excited. Of course, right when I go to film, she starts making all this noise. Okay, I had some running around to do, like I said today, and I thought I would show you what I got. I went to a couple small local businesses just because I needed some stuff, and I could have grabbed some of it on Amazon, I feel like, but didn't want to. I wanted to shop local, and I was already out, so I just felt like might as well do that. I'm gonna share these. Some of it I don't know if you will be able to get online, because I know one of it you won't for sure, but most of these other things you can, I believe. I'll link it all below. First thing I got is a wreath. Hi. I've been looking for a flocked wreath that is cute and doesn't have like all this red stuff in it. I mean, I'm not knocking anyone's wreath, just for my personal like vibe. You guys can see like I have the flocked tree. I don't do a ton of color. It's just not me. So I got this cutie from the Plant Junkie. Which, this pine cone, there we go. What was I saying? From a Plant Junkie. She's a local business. She just opened up a storefront. She's the funniest human. And yeah, I just love Isabella.
If you're local to Langley, go check out her shop safely. She doesn't ship online, so this is the thing I was talking about, you can't get online, but I do think she's working on that, so I will definitely share when she does. I went in there originally to get some eucalyptus for my shower because I just love having that in my shower, like fresh eucalyptus. The smell is so nice. And she didn't have any fresh. And as I'm walking out the door, she's just so generous. She was like, just take this eucalyptus, it's dried, so I can put it in a vase. Also, I have learned, if you have eucalyptus, please, disclaimer, if you own pets, I know specifically for dogs, I don't know about other pets, but I'm assuming it's toxic to them, so just like keep an eye on that. I'm lucky that I don't think Banks would eat eucalyptus, but she's eaten questionable things before. We will not talk about that. So if you've listened to Caitlin's live podcast, you from Nashville with Blake and Tia, you know what I'm talking about. Dude, as I'm saying, she doesn't eat things. She's chewing on the tag on this bag I got. Banks. Okay, so that is what I got from the Plant Junkie. Let's do raw canvas next. Amanda is a friend and a client, and she's literally right next to the Little White House Co., which I showed you guys that I was visiting for work purposes, and she spotted me from the window of her office because of my shiny patent leather leggings, so I popped in to say hi to her, and then she just so generously loads me up with stuff. But I got this cute candle from her, the scent is vanilla cream and raw brown sugar, and it smells really good. It smells like a little musky, but like sweet, which honestly I love. And she also gave me a scrunchie, which I haven't even seen. What are these? Oh, it's a tie. This is cute. It's like a pretty blush. This would be cute in like a ponytail or like when you're doing your makeup, or even just like these headbands are so in right now. I don't know if I can do it. I've never done this before with like a tie. I look like, I don't know, like a cute little headband. This color like isn't the best on my skin tone, but it would be cute in a ponytail too. And then the last thing I got, which I always love to stock up on when I'm there, is these Zio sheet masks. They are so good. I love these sheet masks over any other one that I've tried, to be totally honest. They're called Skin Brightening Sheet Mask Anti-Aging Formula. You can't get these at like Sephora because they're not medical grade, I think clinical grade. I don't know what it is that's so different about them formula wise, but I love them. So the next step I got is from Little White House Co. It's actually not gonna spoil the announcement, so I'm gonna show it. And it's all stuff I'm really excited about. They were so generous to me. They are such an amazing mom and daughter team. Wait, I think they're mom and daughter. Pretty sure they're mom and daughter. So yeah, I'm gonna show you what I got. First is this shacket, because I'm freaking obsessed with shackets. I also just like saying the word shacket. Shacket, 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 shacket. It's this neutral plaid shacket. It's such cute tones and it's so soft. So I got that. I got this sweater vest, which is like an off-white cream. It'll be cute with like, not totally sure, but something under it. I don't know. And like a little skirt, or the patent leggings that I was wearing today, I would totally wear with this. And like a white, I'd have to see what crisp white looks like under this, to be totally honest, because this, it might make this look a little yellow. I don't know, sorry, my sweatshirt's white. I'm talking to myself. But yeah, got that, really cute, nice plush, thick knit. And then I also got this frame from them, which is like a rattan. Is it a rattan or a rattan? I'm not totally sure, but whatever it is, I got it. And I'm not totally set on where I'm gonna put it yet. I'm thinking I might put it on that black shelf just to kind of add some, like a pop without it being a huge pop of color. I don't know, to be decided. Also, let's see you guys how long it takes me to put a photo in this. It's got a cute little pelican right now, so could be 2 weeks, it could be 2 years. I also, they sent me everything in this straw bag, which is so sturdy and will be great for a reusable bag. What? A reusable bag when I go grocery shopping, or one day in the summer when I go to the beach. But yeah, that is what I got. I also went to Spent Grounds here, which is local, but I'm not gonna do a grocery haul because I already put it all away, and to be honest, I'm too lazy to pull it all back out.
Thanks. Hi. I love you. Are you in the Christmas spirit? Blink once if you're in the Christmas spirit. Blink twice if you're not. She's in the Christmas spirit, you guys. In the Christmas. Okay, I gotta shut up.
Okay, friends, you're not rid of me yet. I did a workout, but I did not film it because I just was struggling. My legs feel like jello. But don't mind my mess of a kitchen. I just got these handles that I'm thinking of replacing all my hardware with, because I just love the black. That won't stay, but I just love the black contrast. And I also hate how these show fingerprints like so easily. So I don't know if I'm being over ambitious by trying to do this today, but I think that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, well, I'm getting in the zone. Got a handle off. Slight problem. Looks like I gotta go find a different handle.
Okay, so I said that I was gonna share something with you guys before this vlog was over, and I've really left it to the last minute, but I'm really excited to say that basically next time a vlog comes out, we will be 2 days away from my first ever, it's a very bad drum roll, 12 days of giveaways. I've been planning this for a couple months. I've got some really, really great brands involved that I love, I use, and most of them are local, so I'm really excited. You're gonna have to stay tuned to find out which brands are involved, but I have no doubt that you guys will be so excited to potentially win some insane prizes, because every prize has minimum value of $500. 500 buckaroos. That's right. Stay tuned. I will be sharing all the details on how that's gonna work. It will be all done through my Instagram for the most part. That's where the posts will go up, so you can find the details on how to enter there. So make sure you're following along. I can't wait. I've never done this before, so I hope everyone's as excited as I am. But anyways, thank you so much, you guys, for tuning in for another week. I appreciate it so much. I don't know why you like to listen to me talk, but thank you. If there's something that you want to see in an upcoming vlog, whether it's like a Q&A or another haul or more grocery talk or vegan talk or hormone updates or hair extension updates, like, let me know. I'm happy to make sure to work that in, because I want to be giving the content that you guys want to see. If it's more Banks and you don't like me, you're just tuning in for the little bean, let me know that too.
This is pretty much all she does.
On that note, I will see you next week. Love you, love.